What's up, guys? Welcome back to Virtual Reality, to the VR and AR Weekly News. So as you can see, my shelf is getting empty and empty because I will move to a new apartment and I will get a new studio. This will be very awesome. So what's on the list today? Samsung augmented reality contact lenses, OpenXR release, Nolo VR, Respawn VR game, Apple AR, HP Reverb, Facebook brain scanning, Tobii eye tracking, Vive Cosmos, and some Oculus Quest releases. So my name is Voodoo. You can find everything about VR AR on this channel. So subscribe, hit the bell, and don't miss anything. Thanks to my official Patreon sponsors, Woodghost VR, Oppermann Events, and Peter Wasmeier. So let's have some fun with the weekly news and let's go.
Voodoo.de.
So do you remember my last April's Fool? So I presented the virtual and augmented reality contact lenses, but now this is gonna be true. This is true, we don't have the 1st of April and Samsung has a patent for augmented reality contact lenses. Holy moly. And how does that look? It looks like this one. It has a display unit and a hidden camera unit so that it can scan the environment and it can display stuff in front of you like navigation or whatever. Then it has a device layer, the real contact lens, and an encapsulation layer so that everything is protected. And also it will be interacting with your smartphone. So if you have Google Maps or whatever, then it will project this stuff to your contact lenses. Wow, I really want to try this. but keep in mind, this is only a patent. It could never be on the market. But they just want to make sure that nobody else is copying their idea with this patent. So however, this is very exciting and I hope someday I can wear real augmented reality contact lenses. A long time ago, I reported about OpenXR. This is a platform where the VR developers can have a much easier life to spread all their content to every VR headset. And now the OpenXR version 1.0 is released by the Kronos Group, and it will have support of the major VR companies like Oculus and Microsoft and Windows Mixed Reality. Yeah, this is from Microsoft. And I'm not a developer, so I can't explain that very detailed to you. But if you see this picture here, let's go a little bit closer. So for now, this looks like this here, and it's a total chaos. So if you have your VR or AR app number 2, then you produce it for Unreal Engine, and then you have to do it for Steam VR, for Windows Mixed Reality, for Oculus, for Gear VR, and for Daydream. You have to do every single step for that, and this is a lot of work for the developers. This is how I understand that. And with the new OpenXR layer, you have different interfaces here, the application interface. So you only produce your, let's say, the VR app 1 by Unity, and then it will take over by the OpenXR software or interface, and then it's automatically available for all the VR platforms like Steam VR, Windows Mixed Reality, Oculus, Gear VR, and you, as a developer, you don't have to do this every single time again for all the platforms. This is very awesome. And then there's another device plug-in interface. And then you can also use that if you produced it once. You can use it on every VR headset that is compatible with the OpenXR platform. Wow, this sounds very good. So all in all, this will be much easier life for the developers, at least I hope so. And I also think then that the possibility is higher that every VR game will be on every VR platform and also every software. So I really hope that. But I don't think this will get rid of the exclusive games. I don't think so. However, guys, if you are a VR developer and you can explain that better than me, why not write 2 or 3 sentences of the advantages of this OpenXR in the comments below. That would be totally awesome. I think the people would also love it. But that was a little part of that. But I think this is a good idea. And I really hope that the developers are using this now. I really hope that. There will be a new location-based experiences by Sandbox VR. Perhaps you've already seen my video. I've been in San Francisco and I tried the Sandbox VR experience. And that was really, really awesome. They're doing a very good job. And now, they get a Star Trek Discovery experience. Oh, yes, that's true. And if you have a look here, you're standing here in that holodeck. That's totally cool. And the experience will be, depends on how fast you play, 20 to 30 minutes. And of course, this is in the Star Trek universe. Because I really love these Sandbox VR locations, the next time I will be in San Francisco or Los Angeles, I will try this again, of course, for you. And yeah, then we can play this up to six players, and this will be really, really cool. Nolo VR raised $15 million for further development of the 6 degrees of freedom tracking. And I had this set at home. I had it a long time. I tried it a lot of times, but I was really not amused by that. It worked, but it was not really good tracking. Especially when you turn around, it doesn't even work anymore, like with the PlayStation VR tracking. And now they have another 50 million. So for me at home, I cannot see any use cases for that. Because when you buy an Oculus Go for like 150 or 200, and then the Nolo VR set for 200 bucks, then you are like 350 or 400 bucks. And then you can just buy the Oculus Quest that has much better tracking and much better experiences. So I'm not sure if that is a good idea. However, if you have any use cases for that, just write it under the comments. Perhaps I'm totally wrong, but I really also hope that they will develop better stuff with the $50 million. That would be really awesome. The Respawn's AAA shooter will come with a playable demo to the Oculus Kinect 6 in San Jose at September 25 and 26. You will be able to play it finally and, of course, to see that. It's an Oculus exclusive VR shooter, and I'm really curious about that. So as you can see, there is a lot of stuff coming from Oculus exclusive. So Stormland, Asgard's Wrath, and this one. So a lot of cool games are produced there. However, these are all exclusive games. And I really know many people hate that. But what can we do? This is Oculus decision. And but I can confirm that all of these games are really awesome. I played Stormland and Asgard's Wrath as well. And I'm really also looking forward to that Respawn AAA VR shooter. So if you are at the OC6 in San Jose, then you will be able to play it. For me, last time I was at the OC5, but this time, as you perhaps know, I will get a new studio, and this will cost me thousands of bucks, and I cannot afford to go there this year, as it seems, because the flight is around 1,200 bucks. The entrance to the OC6 is 400 bucks, and then hotel and stuff. I cannot afford it. So perhaps Oculus can invite me there. I have no idea, but otherwise you will not see me there. It's impossible now. too much stuff to pay. However, I'm looking forward to this game. So the 2 weeks before, I showed you that there's a rumor that Apple has stopped every VR and AR production or development. And this seems to be wrong, because Apple has a job listing now. And this looks really, really interesting. So there's a graphic engineer, system UI engineer, software engineer, real-time 3D software and stuff. And there's also a demo evangelist. And this means that this guy will show internal employees of Apple all the prototypes, and he will say that, yeah, we are producing a cool AR VR stuff. Do you want to try that? And this is gonna be awesome, I think. I really want to try a AR or VR Apple product. So let's hope for the future that this will be something very, very cool. And there goes the next delay for the HP Reverb. What the heck is HP doing here? So as it seems, they had a small stock of HP Reverbs in the stores for like 20 or 30 minutes, then it was already sold out. And these guys that got the HP Reverbs already told about display issues again. So what the heck? They delayed it to July, they delayed it to August, and now there is again display issues. So what are they doing? What's going on there? And why are they using a small amount of customers as beta testers? Why? Why is that? So I didn't cancel my pre-order yet, but I'm really considering that, because on the one hand, I don't have money at the moment, and the other hand, I'm really not looking forward to that headset anymore. So I can only tell you, do not pre-order this device. Do not. Wait until I have that and I can test it for you. This is what I really recommend. This will not be, you will not be amused by that, I'm pretty sure. So wait a little bit. So Facebook is developing brain scanning for their AR glasses. Holy moly. So this is nothing new, to be honest. Several years ago, I had something that was called Brain Mouse, and it was here on my head. And with my head, I could control the mouse, but that didn't really work. I really hope this is going to be better now. And with this unit, it's with a brain computer interface, then you can write something without using your fingers or stuff. Just think what you will write and it's writing that down. So this is really strange. I'm not sure if we want Facebook to scan our brains. This is curious. I'm not sure if I want to do that at home. I would try that, of course, if that is released, but it will take a long time. Look at these prototypes. This is totally unpracticable for at home. But yeah, they are researching that. And what do you think about that? Write it in the comments below. So there will be a new adventure that's called Time Stall for the Oculus Quest on August 15th. So this game is about a spaceship. And on this spaceship, there will be some incidents or explosions, or something will be wrong. Some machines won't work anymore. And then you have to fix that. And to do that, we can freeze the time temporarily. So we have more time to do that and to fix that stuff. And this is a little bit like the game Just in Time. I showed that on my channel a long time ago. And yeah, this will be on Oculus Quest. I think it will be exclusive only to Oculus Quest, and it will be released on August 15th. So you see, there is a lot of stuff coming for the Oculus Quest, and this seems to be a funny game. So Tobii eye tracking is not only for the Vive Pro Eye anymore. I tried that on the CES in Vegas 2019, and that was pretty impressive on the Vive Pro Eye. So where I looked, there was no latency. There was no latency that I experienced. So that works really, really good. And now it's available for other headsets as well. So the foveated rendering that is possible with the eye tracking, you could save more than 50% performance, because only the area where you just look at is rendered in full quality and all the other stuff not, and you will not really notice that. A lot of cool stuff. I really hope that the VR hardware developers will implement that in their headsets. The thrill of the fight is coming to the Oculus Quest in the coming weeks, the developer says. So this is a boxing game. This is a very old boxing game. I think it was released in July 2016. And it's cool. It's a cool game and you should really try that on the Oculus Quest as soon as it's out, because the Quest has the advantage that you can turn around. There's no cable. This is totally wireless and this would be a really advantage for this game. So if you are a PlayStation Plus member, then you should check out the games that are available in August, because this time there is a virtual reality game inside and it's called Wipeout Omega Collection. This game has full VR support and I tried that for myself and it's so cool. It's a lot of fun. It's very immersive to drive that space ships or gliders or however you call them, and normally it's $20 and now you can have it for free if you are PlayStation Plus members in August. So if you attend the Gamescom on August 2019, this month, I will be there on Tuesday 20th and 21st, the Wednesday, and on the Wednesday, I will do a small community meeting and I will tell you via my Discord. Unfortunately, this is German only, but you can come there and go to the Gamescom channel and I will write you the exact time when we will and where we will meet on Wednesday at Gamescom. And on Tuesday, this is press only day, I have some appointments with all the VR companies and I will try the newest stuff for you on the Gamescom. So who the heck is working at the HTC Vive marketing department? Is this person something drunken or what? What are they doing? So they released a lot of small videos that tells us nothing new. So the only thing is that we know the weight of the headset now, it's 651 gram, but there's nothing else, nothing really special about this. And also, there was a video that announced the HTC Vive Cosmos, but it's very old. It was unlisted on YouTube, and now they decided to make it public. And then for the people, it looked like a new video. So everybody thought, what the heck, we already know this information, why are they releasing that now again? So there's a lot of confusing stuff in the marketing of HTC Vive. What are they doing? What is that about? This doesn't make sense for me. Why don't they say, this is the price, this is the release, this is the field of view, this is everything you need to know about this headset. Why are they releasing this really little pieces of information over all these weeks? I hate this and I cannot understand that. Don't understand me wrong, I really look forward to the Vive Cosmos. It will perhaps be a very good headset, but I totally dislike the HTC marketing campaign. That doesn't make any sense for me. Does it make sense to you? If yes, write it under the comments. Why? Look at this one. This is Philip from Switzerland and he bought my t-shirt, my merch, and this is totally awesome. He told me that he wants to see that in the weekly news and yeah, here it is. Thank you so much, Philip, for that. This is crazy awesome. I love to see guys with my t-shirt. Wow, this is for me, this is a cool feeling. And it would be totally awesome if somebody on the community meeting at Gamescom will wear this t-shirt. That would be a total blast for me. You can support me with buying this merch stuff. You just go under the video, there's a link to Teespring, and there you can buy all this stuff, t-shirts and mugs and pillows and whatever. So thanks to all of my supporters on Patreon and YouTube members. Unfortunately, there's no new Patreon this month. There are even two or three people stopped their support. I don't know why. I think it's because it's the first, and they saw, oh my God, this will be booked from my credit card. I have to stop that. I don't know. It's not so good for me, to be honest now, but I hope I can manage all these costs that come to me. However, the guys that are supporting me, the people, thank you so much. This is totally appreciated. Even or just now at this point, I can really, really need that. So yeah, thank you for watching and see you next time in virtual reality, guys. See ya.